You may not have heard about route preference, but you've almost certainly heard of administrative distance. The good news is that they're the same thing. In this video, we're going to see how the route preference is used for route selection. Routers learn routes from multiple sources, such as OSPF, BGP, and static configuration. If a router learns a route from more than one source, it needs to decide which one is better, so it can be placed into the forwarding table. The question is, how much do we trust each routing protocol? Like all vendors, Junos assigns a value to each one of these to show how much they're trusted. You might know of this value as administrative distance. Juniper calls it the route preference. The lower the route preference, the more Junos will trust the routing protocol. For example, a static route with a preference of 5 will be more trusted, or preferred, than an OSPF route, which has a preference of 10. An OSPF route will be more preferred than an ISIS route. You can see the common values in the table here. This is normally a big table, so I've only included a summary of all the values. See the link in the description for the full table. A nice benefit to this system is being able to manipulate the route preference to get the behavior we want. In the Cisco world, we would call this a floating static route. This is where we have a static route with a different route preference than normal. This makes the static route less preferred than some other routing protocol. The only rule is, we can't change the preference of a local or direct route. If there's a failure in the routing protocol, all of its routes are removed. This leaves the floating static route as the next best option. When we want to mess with the default settings, we configure a qualified next hop rather than a regular next hop. By doing this, we can change the route preference. If you look at the full config, as shown here, you can see how the different preference is associated with a qualified next hop. Looking at the routing table, we can see that both routes are valid. However, looking at the forwarding table, we can see that the next hop with the best preference has been selected. If this were to become invalid for any reason, the less preferred route would be used instead. While we're at it, we can change the default values for static routes. This is also under the routing options hierarchy. For example, we can change the default metric, which is used to choose between two routes that have the same route preference. We can also change the defaults for all static routes. Keep in mind that configuring a qualified next hop will override these settings. If we look at the forwarding table again, we can see that the qualified next hop has now been selected. That's because it has a better route preference than the defaults that we just configured. If you want to practice, there's more in the lab. A qualified next hop can be a tricky concept to get your head around at first. Hopefully, this quiz will help you to see if you've got it. I'm sure you can see the benefit of manipulating the route preference to create a qualified next hop. In the next video, we're going to look at the configuration of OSPF.